So this morning, Jose has come in and he is questioning the level of the laser, which is interesting.
Because he says he's been working this for 40 years and this is no way is it level.
Let's just have a look.
Nivel.
And that certainly is showing a level. To calibrate it, you have to do it from the other side.
That is different, very different. No, no, pero un momento. Ah, yo sé por qué. Tienes razón. Con el trípode. Con el trípode puesto.
Pues.
Con el trípode puesto.
Ahora sí. Pues con el trípode,
with the
tripod on it, te da
la misma línea. It gives you the same line.
Pero aquí falla.
But Jose says something is wrong.
El piso
empieza por debajo de esta línea. Aquí, por ejemplo.
El piso.
El piso tiene que ser unos centímetros por debajo de del nivel.
O sea, esta maestra sí. No saco el piso hasta maestra ahora.
Sí, a esa.
A
maestra.
Esta.
Sí, sí. Pero hay que medir cuántos centímetros hay entre el nivel que he marcado y el nivel de la pieza.
De aquí a aquí.
Sí. ¿Cuántos centímetros hay? Es esa regla más un poco.
Dame un metro, ¿eh?
Pedro, dime, trae un metro. Para yo te la daré.
Yo no tengo metro.
Había uno.
So now Jose has to work in inches because it's the only thing I've got, an inch metro, and it's 4.5 inches. 4.5 inches, no? Cuatro y medio.
Cuatro y medio pulgadas, ¿cuánto es?
Se da como 10 centímetros.
So it's at times like this that it's probably just a good idea to take a short walk, a break from it all. And go and have a look at the beauty of the farm. And I was wondering where that helicopter was flying to and who it was carrying aboard. And it was taking it to that very small village of Mascat that stuck at least 50 years behind the times. And watched the helicopter flying overhead and disappearing behind the mountains down there in Masca. All these things were going through my mind whilst I was thinking about the problems back in the workshop. Luckily, the cement truck arrived and I didn't have to think about it for too much longer.
Eso ahí bien puesto.
Una casita buena, ¿eh? Grande, ¿no? ¿Sabías tú que eras hermano de José, Feto?
Ah, vale, Débora. San Juan. O sea, mucho, bueno, el domingo pasado estuvimos en la pegada, tomando una café. Uy, me regaló un poco de ropa. Oye, okay, ¿cómo está el gimnasio? ¿Estás de acuerdo? ¿Verdad? ¿Estás donde las guaguas están como...? Sí, te la palé, una paleta.
And here's the cement for the floor. At least part of the cement for the floor. Part of the sand for the floor. The cement, I think, is complete now.
Let's have a look at that little trial that we did last week. And here it is. The beginnings of the foundation. So I think I'll leave these boys to it.
Well, here I'm filling the bucket with hardcore. Hardcore that came off the roof.
Da poterlo un pingazzo te dejo preñado.
Venga.
Por el hoyo no te meta.
Lo sé yo.
Mira, ¿no vas a poner el plástico primero?
¿Qué plástico?
El plástico que va por debajo.
El plástico no va debajo, va encima.
¿Plástico va encima?
El plástico va encima, después el atesado final. ¿No?
Esto es el atesado. Esto se pone el plástico y luego esto encima. Y eso ya no va a ver más. Eso ya está terminado.
¿Tú lo quieres así?
Sí, ¿eh?
Pon la regla ahí.
Mira, ¿por qué no llenas este hueco con esto ya?
Qué
esto, por debajo. Pone un poco aquí.
Vacía aquí un poco, ¿ves?
Venga. Vale.
Vamos a mamar esto, me voy a agarrar aquí ya, pero guarda. Se lleva medio camión de... Vale. Vale.
Pero esa parte no tiene plástico, coño.
¿Cuál?
Esa parte donde estás trabajando.
Pero esto es para la maestra.
Sí. Pero todavía necesita plástico por debajo.
No, ya no. Esto no sirve para sacar los niveles. Yo donde voy a trabajar.
Los niveles ya están sacadas.
El nivel este.
El nivel ya está sacada. La tienes que tomar de la medida de la pared, no de lo que estás haciendo tú.
Esto lo vamos. Mira,
venga,
mira acá.
Tú llevas 40 años haciéndote equivocaciones. Venga. Sigue. ¿Qué más te da poner eso ahí con un plástico por debajo?
¿El qué?
El cemento ese. Bueno, hazlo hasta la puerta. Hazlo hasta la puerta nada más y esto lo miramos otro día. Hazlo hasta aquí. No pases esta línea. Y lo miramos luego. Aquí puedes, por ejemplo, pero ¿para qué lo volqueas ahí? ¿Para qué lo pones ahí?
Yo tengo que sacar el otro punto de maestro. Aquí.
Pero ahí necesita plástico, coño.
Ah, verdad. Toma.
Parece mentira. 40 años llevas en esto y
Y los errores siguen.
So in desperation, I'm going back to digging out the hardcore.
Here we have the first part of the floor in. And I hope it's going to be evened a bit more before it's finished. But there we go. He's now going up to the top, to the roof, to finish doing what he's doing up there. Meanwhile, I've been filling this with hardcore, burying it in there. That's going to be our drainage hole, where the one or two pipes are going to flow out of there. So I've dug all this lot out, nearly finished, and all that's gone in as hardcore into here. It's probably not even a third of it. It's 50 bags of hardcore. They're putting a skim across the top of the hole of the roof.
¿Vas a todos los días?
Sí.
¿Hasta qué hora que sí?
¿Eh?
¿Hasta qué hora que sí?
No se empeñó, ¿eh? ¿Qué quieres que le diga? ¿Le pego? ¿Lo dice? ¿Tú me echas una mano o le damos un guantazo?
¿A todo completo?
So now we come to the end of another day.
Dad.
Cállate.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
So now we come to the end of another day working here at Buena Vista Rural Club. And the day when we started the floor of the workshop, we started to fill in with hardcore. There's quite a lot more to go. We finished the skimming of the of the roof, and hopefully we're one step closer to having a waterproof roof. We've still got to put the waterproof membrane down and the paint. So Future episodes of the Buena Vista Rural Club will feature those very things. I will see ya soon. Well, here it is with the skim on the top, dry, and a couple of days later, a windy day today. The whole of the roof now, so waterproofing is almost complete, and we've still got to paint this surface here, and of course the floor is going to have a waterproof membrane, but more or less done. Bit of painting to do now. But as you can see, it's a beautiful day now. And that's going to be the water tank. So quite a few things coming up in the future episodes here of the Buena Vista Rural Club. That's the hole we just broke through. Took all these stones out of there. Well, it's been a few days and we haven't really been filming because there's been lots of activity. You can see for a start that a lot of the rubbish has been taken from here and got rid of. And I've had to bring forward a deadline of the garage. I had to empty the garage at my cousin's house. It's been stored. Things have been stored there for the last, I don't know, 50, 60 years. And all of that was, I was told on Tuesday evening that it was needed quickly by the new owner because the house has been sold. And so I had to bring all the stuff here, or not all of it, but some of it. And you can see some of the furniture behind me. You can see over here bits and pieces that have had to be brought. And we continue with the floor in the workshop at a pace. I'm afraid it's going much too quickly because we're not getting a chance to level the floor as we go. Rather, what we're trying to do is just cover in concrete. But we have, as I said yesterday, in the little bit of filming that I did do with Angel, been able to open up the hole here in the floor for the pipes to go through. The pipes are for the drain and also this one here. We'll come through it and come out through there. This was the steel that we were going to be using underneath the floor, but Jose says he doesn't want to do it. So no floor steel. And then of course there's lots of timber that's come from the other house. But I need to rent now a van to bring the rest of the stuff, which is mainly shelving and workbenches, so as to get the workshop fully fitted. So it's a bit like Napoleon's retreat from Russia, quite frankly. We're in a bit of a state, and trying to get things done as quickly as possible. That's the way it is sometimes. Anyway, speak to you soon. Well, I left my telephone behind and I'd already got down the hill. So rather than reversing, and because I had the trailer on board, I walked back up to the farm house to retrieve it. And I'm now walking my way back down. You can see the car in the distance down there. I think you can see it, probably. Anyway, what occurred to me as I walked up was just how beautiful this farm is and how very lovely the surroundings are. I mean, I know they're pretty amazing already, but wow, it's just so quiet. And you can hear the eagles sailing above, calling to their young as you walk along. Let's see whether we can see them. Or we can see other birds darting around. Not yet. Those trees up there are one of the markers of the land, laurel trees. You can see another one up there on the horizon. Somewhere behind that palm tree. And reverse the lens so that we can see what I'm seeing as I walk down here. You see, you rush in and rush out by car every time, and you don't notice these things, the little things. Birds singing. That's that eagle. Just saw it. There. There it goes. By the way, if somebody can correct me with the species of that bird, if it's not an eagle, a kestrel, or some sort of bird of prey. But if anybody can tell me what species of bird it is, put me something down in the comments. I'd really appreciate that. We're here in the Tenor National Park, and a lot of the birds here are endemic, meaning they don't exist anywhere else in the world. They just live in this little ecosystem. Can you see the man on the parasail? Or woman, maybe, parasailing. Amazing view they must have. And we've had a tough day today, concreting the floor. And I think this little walk was just what I needed to relax a bit. This is a mulberry bush. Yeah, just in case you were wondering what a mulberry bush looked like. It's got a single branch with leaves on it there. So that's a mulberry bush. You can go, here we go around it. Okay, I'm here at the car. The bees are busy. We're all busy. I left my gloves on the top. Okay? We ready?
Fuck off.
Yeah.
That's nice. What did you say, Pedrino?
Mira, mira el parapente, Tom.
Sí.
Mira el bicho.
Yo lo vi.